Shit will not happen if we don't get it together. Now, cooperatively, everybody's got the same legs for a second. Everyone's got the same legs. So everybody use your legs, and the momentum has to go back. When I count to three, everybody back. One, don't let us down. Pearl Jam's about to come out. Two, I know you can do it because it's fucking Seattle. Three, move the fuck back. Move the fuck back. Move the fuck back. Move the fuck back. Backwards, backwards. God damn it, I knew we could trust you. All right, remember, after Pearl Jam, we got more music for you.
Yeah. guys. One and two, one more. Let's go. Keep it cool. Song's called Deep.
I just wanted to say that heroin got me where I am today.
Song's called Deep. We'll be right back. not playing this song for a really long time because it's just really hard to sing it. If you could help out, it would be really cool. You want to try some?
Yeah. good. That those yellow things are holding them.
Nice man.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, Kathy.
Hi, Eddie.
Okay, let's talk about number 29 and the significance of
all this. All right. Number 29 is a friend of mine named Jack McDowell. This is my tribute to him here. He was the first pitcher to win 20 games, and he gave me one of his caps that I wore all through the European tour and the American tour. It was kind of a good luck thing. I always had a good show with it, and he seemed to be playing well as long as we were playing well.
Have you heard that new EP he's got out?
Oh, yeah, it's great. There's a song called Trickle Down that I warm up to before we go on. He's pretty good. George Brett said that if he could sing as good as he pitched, maybe he'd buy some of his records, but I think George is just jealous. I think George ultimately would like a record of his own. George is trying to cash in on the grunge scene. He's just jealous.
What about you? Have you heard the rest of the you guys thought about Pew or about using, doing maybe a gig with Pew or something like that?
Oh, yeah, I heard they actually do a really good acoustic version of Alive, but
really?
He hasn't played it for me.
There was a gig apparently at CBGB's. Tell me about that and how Jack had to move next door.
Oh, yeah, well, what I remember is that all I know is we pulled into town, we're doing sound check, and this really tall guy, I saw his silhouette walk up to the stage and turned out to be Jack. I guess they were going to be playing at CB's, but we kind of bumped him to the art gallery next door, which I heard he played a rocking set. That was right before they went on tour with the Smithereens.
So that was okay with them, right? Is that how you met?
Yeah, no. We had known each other for a while. His girlfriend and my girlfriend, we've been friends for years and years and years. So plus I've always been a big Chicago sports fan, so it's kind of cool to be able to know somebody. Maybe I'll get to sit in the bullpen someday or something.
Are you gonna do the Star-Spangled Banner
Wednesdays? Yeah, but I would play electric guitar like Jimi Hendrix. And I'd have it be wireless, so I'd start the song at home plate, and I'd run around and then slide into home to finish it off, and I imagine the crowd would pretty much boo me. It would be a worse showing than Roseanne.
Yeah, that would be pretty bad. Tell me about this, what you guys have created.
Okay, we're here in Seattle. This is Drop in the Park, and if you drop in the park, you can drop in the grass, you can drop in here.
Wow, look at that.
You can pretty much drop anywhere. It's a free show. It's a free atmosphere. It's taken a while to actually make it happen, but we did make it happen. We went through the mayor, and first he said no, and then everyone else in the community said yes, and so he had to say yes, which is a great example about voting, because that's the other reason we're here, is to register people for November. And it's great that everyone proved that they can make a difference, and maybe it'll get them excited about doing it come November.
We were at the press conference, and you guys were a little upset, right?
Well, we had spent 2.5 months preparing it and planning and making sure that we had all the Santa cans and we had all the buses. You saw how smoothly everything ran today. And it was going to be just as smooth 2 months ago, but they decided to turn it down. They thought there was going to be too many people, and they also thought that no one would care. You know, it was pretty much more trouble than it was worth. But people came out and spoke out, and so that's why we get to do it today. With the same bands, Seaweed and even Cypress Hill. It's cool.
Seaweed's the first time these guys will be able to vote in a presidential election. We talked about that a little bit. Tell me about you set the vote. Did you do an absentee ballot?
Yeah, I did an absentee ballot just in case. I wasn't sure. But there's... it's interesting how difficult they make it in some cities, especially like college towns. I've learned all this stuff about how they kind of don't make it that convenient for you to register. And what that says to me is that they really do consider the youth voting crowd a strong public that that could make a difference. And so they kind of like, they worry about that kind of stuff. I'd love to like prove them right and do make a difference. I'm sorry, I was being interrupted there. Quite a character.
Yeah.
I think it's worth it, though. I mean, I was talking about the Seattle scene before. It really boils down to people on a small level coming out and being responsive to the shows. That's just a springboard, so these small bands can like get across the country and then get their music heard. We had no idea it would springboard us to this point, but the fact is you got to appreciate that. Not every city has that.
tip this one over. Your manager just went in.
All right. Maybe we could film a little. I'd like to introduce everybody to our manager, Kelly Curtis. All right.
Great, that's good. We started talking about the money a little bit. Is there any figure about how much this all came to?
Well, the first figure I heard was a little bit shocking, and so I decided not to get any figures after that. I figure it's worth it either way. You know, everyone says I should sign my own checks and I should really care about money. I personally think in the end that would change me. I'm somebody used to living from paycheck to paycheck. I ain't gonna change just so I can, like, make sure I'm rich. That doesn't really have anything to do with me or my lifestyle.
You're gonna have skateboarders, ramps, what happened to that?
Well, last time we had organized this, we had permits to build a ramp, and we had skaters from San Diego and Northern California, Newport, come up. What we did last time when they canceled us, the day after, we built the ramp and built a small stage. Seaweed still played, about 500 people showed up, and it was just off in Little Ranch in outer Seattle. It was cooler than anything I've ever witnessed. It was all right.
That was cool. Couple basics. What's next for the band?
What's next? We're gonna play some shows in Hawaii in a couple days, kind of an excuse to get over there to surf, and then I'm just gonna go back in my apartment. I got a guitar and I got a tape recorder, and just gonna see what happens. I've learned a lot. I've been, like, pretty much sponging everything up, so I'm just gonna go squeeze my sponge.
You think the city's changed its mind about doing these types of things?
Well, hopefully if today goes good, it'll change its mind. I mean, obviously they were pushed into doing this one, and we plan on doing it, like, every year, whether it's our band or just us supporting it, you know. I think it would be a good thing for the city and just for the youth here. You know, they don't have skateboard parks in Seattle, and they don't have a lot of things to do, and they just shut down another all-ages club. So you're gonna need to give. There's a lot of youth here, and they're, you know, unless you, like, keep them some dude, they're gonna rebel. You know, not everyone in this country is happy sitting home watching TV. Even MTV.
You were a tour when they were sending all this up.
Yeah, well, I mean, we're still very much involved. They have fax machines and stuff nowadays. You can keep up daily, yeah.
Yeah. Hey, I was curious. I'm gonna try to see if it catches on. I think it's pretty much everything I need to.
Cool.
Hey, you got stuff written on your hands?
Hey,
yeah.
Messages, yeah, what is this on your hand?
Yeah. No, I ain't showing you what's on my hand.
Phone numbers, what?
No.
Okay.
I write lyrics all over my body. Today I'm pretty clean. I took a shower this morning finally, so right before I shower, I transcribe everything I've written on my body. Sometimes you don't have notepads, but I usually have a permanent marker. It's just really a problem when I start writing. I run out of room and start writing on my back. Some of the words get kind of misconstrued. But it makes for good songs. Confusing lyrics, parts of your body.
I meant to ask you about this too. I don't know if we've talked to you about this before, but your Pearl. How's she doing?
Oh, yeah, well, she's dead.
Oh, I didn't know that.
It's my great grandma. She's been dead for a long time. She sure would be happy to be seeing all of this, though.
Yeah? Good old Pearl. Okay, man, I want to get, if I can, a tight shot of your helmet.
Sure.
Just so I have something to cut.
Can I talk about Jack again? I didn't like that shit that I was... Do you have room?
Yeah.
I'll show you at the end of this little bit.
Okay, Jack, let's talk about Jack.
Number 29. His name's Jack McDowell. In Chicago, he's known as Blackjack. He can throw the ball probably about 90 miles an hour. Someday I'll be able to play catch with him, and I'm really nervous about that time because I know he'll be really casual and then just whip one of those 90 miles or right at me, right at my face. But I think I'm ready for him. And if he does that, then I'll just invite him out on stage in front of 30,000 people and see how he fares. But he's a good guy, and I hope he keeps winning. As long as he does well, we seem to be doing well. And so, again, that's why I wear his number in tribute. And he's also really cool because as much attention as he gets in Chicago and everywhere else, he doesn't act like a celebrity, which backs up my motto about how celebrities suck. Can you see it?
Make sure people don't come crashing forward. Front line, are you ready? Are you ready front line?
Celebrities suck. I made this up after the MTV Awards. I was a little inundated by celebrities.
Pounds.
Level.
Should be me.
I could hold it.
No, that'd mean okay. There'd be an arm.
Okay.
That's cool. That'd be good. So I got pretty crazy up there. What was Eddie up to?
Typical hijinks, doing his thing. I mean, being back in Seattle was kind of heavy for everyone, you know. Yeah. It's like the end of the year and stuff, and everybody's friends are here, so
yeah.
Just like the energy was good. So got Eddie, you know, the better the energy, the crazier the Eddie.
What about you guys have this policy this time around? Is this like a policy of all your concerts about people can record?
It's no harm done kind of thing. You know, whenever it's possible, we definitely don't have any bad trips about it. It's all right with us. Yeah.
That's okay.
Yeah, I mean, we don't mind.
Now, this is a pretty big endeavor. How did you guys manage to do this while you were on the road?
Actually, the Lollapalooza Family of Fun tour ended last weekend, so it's like, you know, we had a week to kind of regroup and kick back, and this thing's been trying to be set up for a long time, and we got to pull it off. So
was there details where you guys were on the road?
Actually, no, we had a really great force here.
Yeah.
Our manager Kelly Curtis and everyone, Ken Deans, so many people were working really hard for this. City of Seattle really helped a lot, and you know, everybody pulling together.
You remember
made
the press
it happen.
Conference?
Oh yeah. That was a hectic time, you know.
Yeah.
So it's a little easier.
A little upset.
Yeah, but it happened, and all that's in the past, and maybe we'll do it again next year.
You think so?
I hope so. It'd be nice. It'd be a nice way to end every tour.
Yeah, it'd be okay. It'd be
yeah,
okay.
We'd be into
well,
it.
Well, hey man, thanks. I appreciate it.
Yeah, I've been really keeping my eye on youth culture, and I think it's good that young people get together for something positive, like voter registration, which is the most basic thing, but in our real apathetic country, you got to start somewhere. So once everybody's registered to vote, you can go out there and learn about the issues and then apply that in the ballot box. It's a real important year, and it seems like it's the old guard against the new. You have the World War II generation of George Bush, and you have the baby boom generation of Bill Clinton. And I think youth culture has to emerge in the 90s and take the horse by the reins and make some improvements in the status of the nation. It's hard to say, really. It's up to everybody. I'm not really into leaders. I'm not into any kind of ideology. I'm just, you know, you just gotta change starts with yourself. So.
I'm pleased that we got to do it at all. You know, it was only because of everybody writing in and showing their displeasure at the cancellation of the last show that we were able to do today's. So, you know, the last day, it was a really beautiful day out, the day it was supposed to be in when it was over at Gasworks. But I think any show is better than no show at all.
Tell me again, obviously getting people to register to vote, great cause. That's the ultimate goal here, isn't it?
Yeah, and to, like I said, the fact that it's being done at all today is because people raised their voices. So it's a perfect example of what they can do. And I don't think people... It's really easy to become apathetic and feel like you can't make a difference. So this is just proof that you can, and they can do the same thing in November. I mean, the bars are closed anyways. You might as well go out and make a day of it, make a difference.
A lot of people are saying only in Seattle could Pearl Jam carry this off.
Oh, I don't know about that. I mean, there's a number of bands that could pull it off here, and there's a number of other bands that could pull it off across the country. I mean, people listen to music and people care about music, especially nowadays when you need to get strength from things like music and art. I think things like this could happen everywhere if people just organize themselves. It's a really good thing. It's a good vibe today.
It is, definitely. And one more quick question. You mentioned before the group has said that it feels in part that it owes something to Seattle, and this concert is a gift, obviously, to get them to vote as well, but a nice gift to Seattle. Do you feel that you do owe these citizens who've been so supportive and adoring of you guys?
Oh, adoring. Well, the fact is that they talk about the Seattle scene. I mean, what that is boils down to is that people go out and see music and are responsive to it. Some friends of mine came up from San Diego last night and played, and they were just thrilled at the reaction. I mean, the people went out and reacted. They care about music here. And it was that very small beginning, you know, people coming to the off-ramp or the OK Hotel and seeing bands. I mean, that's what, like, enables them to springboard into, like, crossing the country with their music, you know. We're thankful to be able to do that. We never knew we'd be able to even see other countries or play to big places, or I mean, this. I wish this could be a free show at the OK Hotel. That's the next thing. We have to reopen the OK Hotel. That would.
Okay, good. That's the yellow thing they're holding.
Lorium officially sanctioned Cool.
Why?
Because he said I was. Movie said no. Now you know.
Where's Kelly?
Up here.
Yeah.